Hello everyone, today in Sanghi's Cookery we are going to see how to make a Malpua. Malpua is nothing but a sweetened pancake which is dipped in sugar syrup, and this is mostly made during Holi and Diwali time, and this is usually served as a dessert along with rabdi, which is nothing but a sweetened milk along with some nuts. It is a very tasty and interesting preparation. So before we go into the procedure, if you are watching my video for the first time, I would request you all to subscribe to my channel and also click on the bell icon for further interesting recipes and notifications. So today I'm going to show you how to make the Malpua using the wheat flour instead of maida. I've taken 3/4 cup of the wheat flour. So I'm adding 1/4 cup of rava. This is the fine rava. Mix it up nicely. I'm also adding 1/2 teaspoon of cardamom powder. This is for flavor. I'm also adding 1/2 teaspoon of soft powder. So mix up all the ingredients nicely. So I'm just going to add the warm milk little by little. Add milk little by little so that the lumps will not get formed. Otherwise, if you just add everything in one go, there are chances that the lumps might get formed. So after adding the entire 1 cup of milk also, if you see the consistency is still thick. So it has to be in flowing consistency. So I'm adding some more milk. So I'm adding the entire 1/4 cup. Mixed it up. So now if you see, it's in a pouring consistency. Like it is not like very watery. At the same time, you can pour the batter. So this is the consistency. So I've used 1 1/4 cup of milk for this recipe. Just make sure that there are no lumps. So to this I'm also adding 2 tablespoons of fresh cream. You can even use the homemade cream or malai if it's available. So now I mixed up the batter well. It's in a correct flowing consistency if you see. So now we will allow this to rest for some period of time. So the more time you give, and if it ferments naturally, it will be better. It's been about 2 to 3 hours. Basically, it has to be slightly in a flowing consistency. If you feel it is very thick, then probably you can just add a little bit of milk or little bit of water. So I'm just adding, say, about 1 tablespoon of water to just adjust the consistency. So you can also add a little bit of saffron strands in the batter. This is optional. In case if you don't have saffron strands, you can just ignore. Now we'll see the rabdi preparation. For the rabdi preparation, see, basically I have prepared the rabdi in a thick form, because whenever I make any kind of desserts, I sometimes keep this in a thick form, so it will be easier for us to make any kind of a dessert. So now the thick rabdi can be diluted by adding some milk. So in the milk, I'm adding the prepared thick rabdi. The rabdi preparation is very easy. All you have to do is, you have to take a full cream milk and boil it nicely until it comes to a thick consistency. And once it comes to the thick consistency, add the sugar, because after adding sugar, again it will leave water. In this, you will have to add the kesar or the saffron, and the also added the pista powder and the almonds powder. So that is the only difference. Now after diluting it, you can see that the rabdi is in a nice flowing consistency. It is still thick and the color is also just perfect. I'm going to switch off here and I'm going to refrigerate the rabdi. For the sugar syrup, I'm going to take 1 cup of sugar. For 1 cup of sugar, I'll be adding 1 cup of water. And I'll allow the sugar and water to boil until it comes to 1 string consistency. So now the sugar syrup is boiling. At this time, I'm just going to add 2 pods of cardamom. So this is going to be just an additional flavor to the sugar syrup. I'm not adding any other essence. So the sugar syrup for this is exactly the same way as to how we prepare it for the gulab jamun sugar syrup. So now you can see that the sugar syrup has boiled nicely. If you see, 1 string consistency. You just press it and you can just see a small line. So that is the first string. So at this stage, I'm just going to switch off the gas. Before we switch off the gas, I'm also going to add a little bit of the color. This is the yellow color. So now I'll switch off the gas. Now the sugar syrup is also ready. So we'll just keep this aside. All we have to do is to fry the malpuas. I'm also going to add a few strands of the saffron. So this will add to the flavor of the sugar syrup. So again, this is optional. If you want, you can add. Otherwise, you can just leave it. All the saffron, cardamom, everything is going to add to the richness and the flavor of the malpuva. So now we're going to heat up the pan. For that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a mixture of both ghee as well as oil. Basically, few people do only with oil, few people only with ghee. But I am using a mixture of both. Preferably use a flat bottom pan. So let's heat it. I'm adding more of oil and little less of ghee. Okay, now the oil is heated up. So we are going to add. So I'm just going to add the batter. You can even add small portions like this. Once it puffs up, you can even invert it. So you can see that it's nicely puffing up and coming. So I suggest that you do this in a very low flame, low to medium flame. So meanwhile, if you want to do banana malpuas, I've taken a small elaiki banana. I'm going to put this in the mixie jar and I'm going to grind it into a smooth paste. And I'll be adding in the batter. That is also another version of doing the malpuva. This is just another option, which I'm just letting you know. So once it is done, I'm just going to take it out. Take out the excess oil. You can just drain it. And then put it in the sugar syrup. So let it coat nicely on the sugar syrup. As I told you, I've just ground one small elaichi banana into a smooth paste. To this, I'll be adding two ladles of the same batter. Nicely mix it up. You can add 2 to 3 ladles. In the next batch, I'm going to make the banana malpuva. So this is the banana malpuva which I'm adding. Keep it in the low flame and keep cooking the malpuvas. So after adding the batter, do not disturb it for at least for about a minute before you invert it. Slowly you can invert it. Let it get cooked on the oil and ghee mixture. After it gets cooked nicely, you can drain this with the help of a spoon and transfer to the sugar syrup. I'm going to take the malpuva from the sugar syrup and I'm going to place it on the serving plate. So on top of this, we're going to add the cold rabdi which we have prepared. On top of this, we're going to garnish some sliced almonds and pistachios. So our delicious malpuva with rabdi is ready. So this is made without adding baking powder or maida. So more healthier form. So I hope you'll try out this recipe and if you like it, please share it with your friends and relatives. Have a sweet day.